joining us from the soon-to-be-hit TV show, Surviving Jack.
Oh, that was a dramatic like, yeah. pause. Right?
Well, you got to do the dramatic pause for this TV.
Oh, I love it.
It's Claudia Lee.
Ooh, Claudia.
Oh, you got that the how we Mexican
Ooh,
pronunciation
I
on that.
I like it.
So you're clearly Mexican.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yes.
Can't you tell by my complexion?
Yeah. Well, I'm Mexican. I'm light complected.
Yeah, would you believe nice. That he is Mexican?
No, I would not.
You wouldn't?
What would you guess? If you just had to take a random stab at his nationality.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't even know what
Look
to say.
Look at him trying to make his eyes wide. Yeah. Do you see it?
Go ahead and say Asian. You can say it. That's what everybody
else He was going,
does.
What do you think I am?
Everyone says Asian?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They do.
Eyes are a little...
Which is fine.
Are just, you?
He's no. kind of Asian-y. No. He's Asian-like.
It's believable,
Which
though.
Is good. Al, I just want to let you know...
I don't know what to say anymore.
Lose. It's fine.
Before you say anything wrong, Al, she is 17.
Oh, I thought your character was just 17. I was about to put my Mac on, girl.
Aw, no.
No.
Okay, wait, so you are 17.
Yes.
And the character you're playing on this new television show, Surviving Jack, is also 17.
Yes.
But the show's set in the 90s.
Yes, which is really cool.
Well, this is cool, though, because in the 90s, I was a lot younger than I am now. So
Definitely.
So we could just act like we're stuck in the 90s, and I can still hit on you. So
I love it.
Yeah.
Totally.
So what kind of research did you do?
Well, I caught the tail end of the 90s, so I was, like, listening to Britney Spears and seeing Backstreet Boys, Rockin' the Jorts, mm-hmm. the jean shorts.
Wait, you don't still do that? I do.
I don't. Not, like the long shorts to your knees. Yeah. That is not a cute look. But I did lots of fun research. I was looking up, you know, Kelly Bundy and Tori Spelling and looking at, you know, Saved by the Bell and all of those kind of, like,
Full
fashion.
House.
Yeah, the fashion sort of inspiration. And that's kind of what my character went through. And she does not repeat an outfit, which is really cool.
That is fun.
See, that's a girl thing, though. I try not to. But the older I get, I found I start getting lazier.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, like some things I really like and I just want to wear again. Do
the
you
problem
outfits?
Is, if she gets to never repeat an outfit, there's nothing you'd want to take home and wear, right? Because 90s fashion was pretty
it's
heinous.
Coming back.
Oh. I did. I took some stuff with me. I had to take something. I couldn't just leave.
What'd you steal?
I stole a really cool, it was like a hot pink, almost kind of turtleneck crop top. With
the one Britney Spears used to always wear?
Kind of, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And then I have some of like the plastic hoops. It's really cool. I love it.
There's a little Clueless in there. I remember going through that phase. I loved so,
Clueless.
Crop tops
was so
back.
Chic, though. That was like, oh my God, fabulous Beverly Hills. Like, get me some of that.
Well, it's very interesting they are setting this series in the 90s because just like the Goldbergs on a different network, they're set in the 80s. So mm-hmm. what do you think is like, I guess the nostalgia, you just automatically have a built-in audience that's going to be clamoring to see this show.
Yeah, and our show, it's also what viewers are going to really relate to. It's very real. It's like a real family. When you sit down and watch the Dunleavy family, you mm-hmm. feel like you're part of their family.
Yeah.
And not every family's perfect, and our show depicts that completely. And we go through, you know, family struggles like every family does, but at the end of it, there's love there. There's not arguing. It's a loving family, and it's really relatable.
So on the show, your dad on the show is a former military guy?
Yes.
Who's very by the book, and your mom on the show wants to go back to law school, right? So you're stuck with dad at home all the time.
Yeah, and he's kind of taking over the head parenting sort of role, and we're surviving him as much as he's surviving us, which is really cool.
And it's based on a real life family, right?
Yes.
Is it really?
Based off of the book written by Justin Halpern, who's our executive producer, called I Suck at Girls.
We all suck at girls.
I suck at girls big time.
Yeah. How many people can relate?
It's a really great book. I loved reading it and I was laughing out loud. That's how funny it was.
So, did you get to meet the real characters?
Justin is practically like Connor Buckley, who plays my brother, mm-hmm. that's Justin. Mm-hmm. I know his father visited set, but I wasn't there, which I was really bummed out.
Is his dad as hot as your TV dad?
I don't really like say that my TV dad is hot.
Your
but,
TV dad is hot.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Is she allowed to say that? If
yeah.
I think so.
I'm not going to say he's hot.
Nah.
He's
she
like
can
my
separate.
Dad. Yeah. I hang out with his daughter.
Does he do a lot of hot shirtless dad scenes?
Oh yeah, there's hot shirtless Christopher Maloney scenes.
Awesome.
There are some sex scenes between him and Rachel.
Julia Roberts should have picked him in Runaway Bride.
Yeah,
I'm saying.
Other than that excitement, my character, she wears a wrestling uniform for one of the episodes.
You wrestle? Mm.
I have to wrestle in the show, which was an experience in itself.
Really?
And there's a fun homecoming episode, too, mm-hmm. with lots of dirty dancing.
Now, were there things, since you've been acting for a while, I'm sure you've had to miss out on some of those like high school moments like that, right? Like proms and stuff like that?
I actually go to a normal high school, and I choose to miss out on those.
Why is that?
Those experiences, because I really am kind of like the odd one out. I don't really care to go to high school proms or dances.
Really?
Well, you get dressed up for red carpets all the time, so that's like your prom over and over.
I don't hang out with, like, I have friends at high school, but, like, to be really honest, I've had to grow up in a way.
A little bit.
Of my friends are kind of, like, 25 plus, so.
Oh, cool. Yeah. We're 25 plus.
Yeah!
Wait,
so do you live with family? Or are you living alone and then going to, living alone in Hollywood?
No, I live
and
with
then
my parents.
Okay.
and I go to high school, but I'm hardly ever there. Like, I've only been there, like, maybe 2 weeks out of this whole year.
Are you going to graduate on time?
Yes, I am. I'm actually graduating early. I'm a junior that's graduating this semester.
Oh. How do you not go to school and still graduate?
How do you do that?
I went to school and barely graduated.
She keeps up with her studies.
How do I do that? I've just been on a really fast kind of
fast track
for high school and also just taking advanced classes.
You're very focused.
Thank you.
I think girls would be very jealous, though. I mean, girls are already jealous when you're pretty and you go to school every day and you're normal. But when you're making money and famous on a TV show and pretty, I bet they're pretty mean.
Yeah, but they've kind of learned to accept it. They can't fight it.
You just write a song about it like Taylor Swift and become a billionaire.
you live in L.A.?
I do live in L.A.
So it's probably a little bit normal.
Yeah.
Some kids from high school get a little famous.
Yeah.
Definitely is.
Well, since you play a character in the 90s, we're going to see just how much of an expert you have become in all your research on all things 90s. If you don't mind, we're going to play a little game.
Yes, go ahead.
Uh-oh.
Our game is called Fresh Prince, Friends, or Full House.
Okay, so she...
Fresh Prince,
Friends, or Full House.
Are you familiar?
Yes.
With
Do I pick one of them?
I'll say a name, I'll say a phrase, and you either answer.
Oh my gosh, okay. Fresh Prince,
Friends, or Full House.
Cool.
Easy enough, right?
You might shock us.
Well, how's your confidence right now?
I'm very confident.
All right, good.
Oh, really?
Good.
We're going to play softball with you. We're going to start with Uncle Jesse.
Full House.
Duh.
Ding.
Come on.
Ross and Rachel.
Friends.
In West Philadelphia, born and
Fresh
raised.
Prince.
Oh, wow. You're good.
Most of my days.
You're good.
You got it, dude.
Full House.
Yes.
Had to think, though.
Yeah, you did.
Uncle Phil.
Fresh Prince.
Yes. That's right. May he rest in peace.
Rest in peace,
yeah. Just
Kidding. Smelly Cat.
I'll say Friends. I don't know.
Yep.
You're right.
It was Phoebe's song.
About the Smelly Cat. DJ Jazzy Jeff.
Fresh Prince.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
You're good.
She is good.
Dang good.
How many have you gotten right so far, Al?
Three.
Like we can test that.
Yeah, right.
Central Perk.
Friends? I don't know.
That's right.
Yes.
Yes. That's
you
right.
really did
that's
your right. homework on
Thank
the 90s.
That's just because it's based in New York. I didn't even know that one.
Really?
Central Perk, what was that?
That was the coffee shop they hung out in every day.
Oh, Central Perk.
Oh.
Glad we weren't playing with you, JC. I think she passed.
What's your least favorite thing about the 90s?
The denim.
The denim. I have a little bit of some hate for the denim, but the 90s had so many cool things too. Like my character, she always has her Walkman.
Mm-hmm.
That would always skip when I would run with it though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She had that. Yeah.
The Walkman or the CD player
I
Walkman.
I had the CD and I would run with it.
And it would skip.
It's like, how did I even get through that?
Yeah. When I grew up, I had the CD player.
Yeah.
And I would travel around with my NSYNC.
I had the cassette with Boys to Men on there before I went to sleep every night.
Nice.
Okay, who's your favorite artist of the 90s, of that time period?
Of that time period?
Yeah.
Well, I've learned so much, growing with the show and listening to all the music that we have. I danced, now I'm giving you guys an exclusive.
Oh, nice.
There was a song that my character had to perform to. It was by Seal. It was
Kiss from a Rose?
Not Kiss from a Rose. Closer? No, what was the... God, I'm blanking on the song.
It's Seal.
A fast Seal song?
Sing it for us a little bit.
A little bit crazy.
Crazy, yeah. Yes. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a cool song to listen to, but I always listen to the Backstreet Boys. That's my jam.
Oh, Kelly's gonna love it.
Okay, now
and NSYNC. I had both of them. Oh,
that's okay.
I had Backstreet Boys first. Watch and the back, I had the watch. Okay, from Claire's.
Okay,
that plastic.
There you go.
That's commitment.
Wow. I got my ears.
Yeah,
you went
Claire's.
All in.
Yeah, we did.
Well, Claudia Lee on the new show Surviving Jack, premiering on Fox Thursday night. We're so excited. We're one
Thank
of the first
you.
Stops you made before the big debut.
Yes.
Can't wait to watch you dance on the show.
Yeah.